There is a private firm known as Vigilant Video that is now focusing on collecting as much data on us as possible so they can sell it to law enforcement and to other private companies. Now, this is an ongoing problem in the country. You guys are all aware of it. Our privacy is being violated, and it's all being done either in the name of national security or just general safety. And that's what Vigilant Video is using to sell this. They're saying, look, we want to help police, and you know, we're going to improve facial recognition data. We are going to collect as much information as we can from people, including license plate numbers and stuff like that. We're gonna compile it into this database, and you know, it's gonna be good for everyone.
And yet, in every science fiction movie I've ever seen, it never turns out good, does it? I mean, you could look at every movie and book from, you know, 1984 and iRobot and Minority Report and Total Recall, and the list goes on and on and on, Blade Runner, that all of this technology and this acquiescence that we just let all of our information and our digital footprint and then our eyes and everything is going to be tracking us constantly, and we're all gonna be wearing Google glasses and we're all gonna be spying on each other, and what happens when your Google glasses are hacked into and you don't even know it and you're watching someone naked that then is all over the internet. I mean, all of this stuff is just, it's just building and building and building, and I wonder what happens when we get to the breaking point.
Well, I think eventually it's gonna get to a point where everyone's dirty laundry is gonna be out there and we're just gonna become desensitized to it. At least that's the only good possibility I could think of. I mean, I really wish that we could fight back against this, but I feel like we've already crossed the line. It's really, really difficult for us to move back and protect the privacy of people living here. Now, just to give you an example of what this group says out there, like, they're very, very transparent about what their efforts are. They say that they have plans to create the largest private sector law enforcement database in the world by combining plate reads with commercial databases, face recognition technology, and more.
Why is a private firm doing this? Also seems odd to me. Not that I'd be much happier if the government is doing it, but why is a private firm jumping into this foray? It just seems odd to me.
I think that the private firm is doing something extremely smart. I don't agree with it, but they see that there is this thirst for private information, right? Yeah. They see that the government wants it. They see that law enforcement wants it. I mean, we've become a police state. And when I say that, people think that it's melodramatic, but I don't think it's melodramatic at all. When you have the Department of Justice obtaining 2 months worth of phone records from the Associated Press, and basically intimidating whistleblowers and leakers, and when you have all of this private information being collected on you on a regular basis, I mean, we live in a police state. What do you think this is used for? Is it really about national security?
Right.
I'm sure that it partly is, but I think the majority of it is about intimidation.
Yeah, and I think this issue between liberty and security versus privacy and your right to own yourself, I think this is gonna be the biggest issue for the next 10 years. Because the technology, we got it too fast. You know, you could look at Facebook as like the simplest example of this. When Facebook was cool, like 5 or 6 years ago, we all got on there, everyone thought it was great, you gave it all your information, every picture you ever had, and every, oh, I'm friends with him, and that's my mom, and now you look at Facebook, this is how I view Facebook, and it's like this disastrous conglomerate of mixed up messages and all this stuff that you didn't realize was public, and your phone number's accidentally on there, and your email, and it's like, we're gonna see this with all this technology. We keep getting it, and we don't really know what it is until much later.
I mean, you're absolutely right about that, and also, privacy settings, I feel like, are purposely confusing, right? Like, terms and conditions are purposely confusing. They've always been purposely confusing.
Are you saying you don't read the 40 pages of terms and conditions and you just click OK every time?
Believe it or not, I remember we did a story about the new privacy settings for Facebook once, and I read through everything. And you have to really sit there and pay close attention to the wording, what it means. Sometimes things are made very, very vague or broad. So I don't blame everyday Americans for not knowing what they're getting themselves into. But I worry about this constantly because although I have nothing to hide, I'm an open book.
It's not about hiding. It's not about
hiding. It's about feeling like, you know, a stranger will meet you and not know who you are until you disclose that information, right? Anyone can go online, type in my name, and they will know everything about me. And of course, part of that has to do with the fact that I do this show, right? But right. I feel like I put stuff on social media thinking it's private, but a lot of times it's not.
Right.
It's crazy.
Well, and you also just don't want to think that the government or some other private agency is categorizing all of this and combining it and doing God knows what to it that's going to be then sold to some other firm and then sold to the government. It's a big mess. But it's interesting stuff because it's happening. We're watching it happen and we're aware of it, mm-hmm. and yet we don't know what to do.
I know, it's incredible. And also, look, I understand why the Associated Press is upset about what the Department of Justice has done, right? But I don't see them freaking out about what this private firm is doing with the private information of American citizens. You know, how they haven't really panicked about that at all since it's been happening during the Bush administration.